You had loads of roasted chicken in your life. Easy, effortless, and most important, tasty. This is not the chicken I deserve, but it's the chicken I need. 10 minutes of prep work is all I need to get this chicken ready. I have adjusted this recipe many times, but now I think I've done it. I will add something new to my blend, and hopefully we'll make this the chicken we need in our life. Let's cook. I'll start by doing my marinade in the food processor. I'm going to add salt, white pepper, cayenne pepper, and chili. You can use any chili you like. I'm using bird's eye chili here. Garlic, turmeric, onion powder, garlic powder, smoked paprika, white wine, some sugar, and a little bit of olive oil. And now the extra touch. I'll add some lard to the blend, because lard is tenderizing, helps keep the meat juicy, and will carry all the other flavors into our meat. At least, I hope so. Just blend it all together until you have a nice, smooth paste. This on its own smells amazing. And this is the paste consistency I'm looking for. A real nice, smooth paste. To get our chicken ready, you start by cutting around the spine. You need a nice, strong knife to do this, or a scissor. Just keep cutting around the spine until you have it all completely removed. And don't forget, save the spine so you can use it in stocks as it's full of flavor. Spread the chicken wide and we have it ready to season. What I found is preparing the chicken this way allows the leg to reach a higher temperature than the breasts, and that's exactly what we want. So the breast will be juicy and the legs will be tender. Dry your chicken skin with a paper towel, and to maximize the chicken flavor, slowly release the skin from the breast to create a space where we can put some of our paste in. Do it gently, we don't want to rip the skin apart. It's a fairly simple process. Then we just grab some paste and we fill that space, and gently with our hands we spread it apart, making sure that all the breasts are covered with our paste. This will help keep the breasts moist as we cook the chicken. And we're going to wrap our paste on the chicken, but only on the chicken meat. On the skin, we're only gonna use salt. We want to dry it up and try and get it as crispy as possible. Then just spread that paste all across the chicken, making sure you're covering all the meat. Put it in the fridge and let it sit there for 24 hours. How hard was that? Now you can go back to sleep and come back 24 hours later. And while you sleep, please think about subscribing to the channel for more recipes like this one. Preheat your oven to 180 Celsius or 360 Fahrenheit and cover your chicken with foil. We're going to place it in the oven and let it cook for 30 minutes. The idea here is this first 30 minutes, we're gonna let that paste melt and start to flavor all that chicken. When the 30 minutes are up, we just remove the chicken from the oven, remove the foil, flip the chicken, and then we're gonna cook it for an extra 30 minutes or until the internal temperature is 71 degrees. I'm measuring the temperature on the breast. As with the spatchcocked chicken, the legs will cook relatively faster. And during this process, every 5 minutes, we're going to check our chicken and we're gonna brush the skin with the sauce. Doing this will add flavor to the skin on the outside and will help to make it crispy. Just keep repeating this process until the chicken is cooked. And after basting for a couple of times, if you want, you can crank up the temperature of your oven to try and really get that skin nice and crispy. And if you don't have a thermometer, 60 minutes are usually enough at this temperature to cook a 1.5 kilo chicken and will be nice and fully cooked. And by opening the chicken this way, we also ensure the legs are going to reach a higher temperature, which is really what we want. But if you have a thermometer, just keep basting until the temperature reaches 71. Removing your chicken and set it aside for rest. This being a very important step of the process. It's looking good! And I will just let the chicken rest for at least 15 minutes. She's very excited from all this adventure. As I check the temperature of the leg, I can see the temperature is much higher than the breast, which is exactly what I wanted. That will give me a really nice tender meat on the legs. To finish off the sauce, I'll just put it into a pan, making sure I scrape all the tray for all these nice pieces of goodness there. I finally chopped some parsley to add to the sauce, and to freshen it up, I'll add some lemon juice. Smells incredible! I'll taste the sauce and adjust with seasoning and add some salt if necessary. Here is perfect. nice and spicy. And our chicken is ready to serve, beautifully cooked with a lovely hot sauce. Moist, delicious. Time to taste. This is not the chicken I deserve, but it's the chicken I need. Juicy, spicy, crispy, everything you want in the chicken. And all the flavors work really well together. And the lard did its job. It's better than using just the marinade I had initially. It helps to keep the meat juicier and it helps to crisp up the skin. And even though you didn't know about this chicken, I'm telling you, you need this in your life. Easy to prepare, easy to cook. The only skills you need is a 5-year-old painting skills. Get a brush, paint over the chicken with the sauce to help that flavor drive into the chicken. This chicken is the one we need. But there's another chicken that we deserve. So check this video out and learn how to make that chicken. It will drive you crazy. See you next time. Ciao.